Welcome to Discovering Grayslake, a podcast dedicated to the stories and people that make our town truly unique. Join us as we sit down with local business owners, community leaders, and everyday residents to hear their tales of triumph, struggle, and everything in between, from the little-known historical gems to current events shaping our community. We'll cover it all in an engaging and informative way. I'm your host, David Wool, and together we'll discover the heart and soul of our town, one story at a time. Today's podcast is brought to you by the lovely folks at Keller Williams North Shore West at the Sink Mars Group. Motivated not by numbers, but by helping you feel at home in our community. Jody Sinkmars and her team are committed to serving Grayslake and its neighbors with the utmost care. Call Jody today at 847-767-7358 or visit the Sinkmars Group online at sinkmarsgroup.com to get started on the path for the home you love right now. This podcast is also brought to you by the Cashmore Financial Group. Financial advice for everyday people. Turn your financial stress into financial success. Call us today, 847-231-6150. All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another episode of Discovering Grayslake. I am sitting at the Grayslake Park District with Shelly Regnier. Shelly, how are you, honey?
I'm great. How are you?
Good. What is your title here again?
I am Superintendent of Recreation.
That means you do a lot of stuff.
Means we cover a lot of areas of interest, yes.
All right, and we're going to dive into those. First of all, I want to thank you because as a resident of Grayslake, I've got to do a lot of things that the park district is involved with.
Great.
So that's what I want to make sure today, that maybe people, we can enlighten some people about some things that the park district does that maybe they don't know about, and also bring light to programs that are people are already involved in.
Absolutely.
So biggest thing when I was writing stuff down is, where the heck do we start? Because you guys much here.
We do. We, and this isn't the best way to go about it, but we say we cover from birth to the grave. So all age ranges, zero infancy parent top programs, all the way to my active adults, a.k.a. over 55 or 50. I don't card anyone.
I'm 51.
I know.
So I'm an active adult?
Yes.
Is that what you're saying?
So I could be too. Right. So we do all different kinds of experiences, whether it's athletics, whether it's crafts, whether it's a family event, you name it, besides the large special events.
Right.
We cover the gamut of activities.
Right. So when I came in here today, actually we're getting ready for bingo today.
Yes.
For active adults.
Nifty 50 bingo, the third Wednesday of every month here at the Park District with me.
Nice. Mm-hmm. You're fun. Are you a professional bingo caller, though?
I am by the farthest thing from a professional bingo caller. I start bingo off with, I will mess up. I will call the wrong number with the wrong letter. I promise that every time we do this.
And I think that's great. And you know, my life's dream is to be a professional bingo caller.
Oh, well.
Maybe today could be training.
We could start a whole new program.
Okay, so let's start. We're actually, what do we call this building? So right off of Atkinson, this building is?
Our recreation center and administrative offices. So we're all housed out of one building. But we also have our new maintenance facility right next door. The guys finally moved out of 477 Lake Street, which is right across from Central. We moved out of there. They have a beautiful facility. We also have our 9-hole par 3 golf course at 1250 Drury Lane.
Drury Lane.
Mm-hmm.
And what's that? Is it called the?
Grayslake Golf Course.
Oh, it's Grayslake Golf Course.
Yep.
Wow, that's hard to remember.
I know. It is.
I don't think a lot of people actually know that golf course. So it's 9 holes.
It's 9-hole par 3. Super sporty. You don't need a driver. You just need a couple irons and your putter. A chipper wouldn't hurt. It's a great, great course to go for 45 minutes to an hour and 15 minutes to golf.
Nice.
Yes, and it's challenging, and I'm scared of that golf course.
Why are you scared of it?
Because there's water, and I don't do well. Golf is not my forte.
Okay. I thought maybe you just didn't know how to swim or something.
Well, no, I could master that. And then we have Jones Island.
Yeah.
Not just the park, but we have our Jones Island preschool building there also.
Oh, that's right, and that's been there for a really long time.
That's the original Park District Administration office.
Are you kidding me?
No, the office was on the bottom, and the preschool was on the second floor.
That's how it all started there.
That's all how it started years.
Do you have any idea what year that was?
Oh,
it was a lot longer than I've been alive.
Yeah, I think we're on our 78th year. Wow. Of operation. Now, I could be wrong. COVID has left me a couple blanky years in there.
Those years didn't count anyway, so don't worry about it.
No, yeah, we've been around forever. We started at Jones Island.
That's so cool. Mm-hmm. And that is, it's kind of nostalgic, too, when you pull into Jones Island, the little hill there with the building. So yeah. Do they still have classes?
We still have our preschool. Our four-year-olds meet over there.
Really?
Plus, we have preschool classrooms here. And we have one more, our young threes preschool program at UPC in downtown Grayslake.
Really?
Yeah.
There's so much going on.
We've never had a facility before we came over here to 240 Commerce. We didn't have a facility large enough to house all of the events. We had Legion Building, which is now the police office, the police department.
Yeah.
So we held dance there, but we were at Jones Island for our preschool. We contracted out with UPC and rented a few of their rooms, and we're still there.
That's crazy. Mm-hmm. Okay, so I dropped my daughter off to work. So you guys actually use for day camp facilities. Mm-hmm. I know you have something at Woodview.
Yep.
And what's at Woodview? That's the...
Right now, Discovery... Adventure Camp.
Adventure Camp.
Is at Woodview. And then middle school right now is day camp, sports camp, and teen camp.
Okay, so I drop my little guy off at sports camp mm-hmm. every day and pick him up. How many kids are there during the day?
We
it's
don't discuss those crazy numbers. No, I'm just kidding. Sports camp, day camp, they have a max of 90 children, and teen camp maxes, I think, at 50, give or take. And I could be wrong on those numbers, but give or take.
Yeah, and what a great service, I guess we call it service, to offer, especially for working parents during the year when your kids are out of school. What do you do with them?
Right. And now we just brought back field trips. Now, we did field trips for many years, and then we had that little pause in life,
right.
But we brought back field trips this year, and a lot of our counselors have never done field trips with us, and the kids have never done field trips with us, but have been coming to camp for 3 or 4 years. So going now on field trips 2 days a week, going to the aquatic center, which is village owned, going there twice a week. Like, we want the kids to be active. Camp is about movement. It's about activity, about experiences and exposures to new people. So that's exactly what camp is.
Yeah, from the socialization aspect to it, to not Huge. Sitting home at your iPad on your that's... iPad all day. And those kids are jam-packed. I look at the schedule of things going on. Like, I think yesterday they were at Barefoot Bay, and
yep.
today they're at the pool.
Yep.
And they're getting experiences to go out different places without their parents.
Yes. So camp very much is like an extension of school without the whole homework process of it.
Thank God.
Where parents don't need to feel that kind of math pressure. But it is. It's exposure. It's socialization. Like, it is fundamentally important. And I don't say that just about school-age kids. I really emphasize it for our preschool program. Like, parents understanding preschool is not about computerizing it. It's not about making it trendy and popular. It's huge social, not only social with their peers, but also taking directions from somebody other than mom, dad, and grandparents, so your teachers, and then understanding where we are developing them with hand muscles, cognitive skills, you name it. It is preschool. I kind of take summer camp and go right back to preschool with that. It's the start. It's the start of so many important skills for life.
Big time.
Yeah.
Big time. One of the things my little guy has learned the most is he gets to bring $5 with, gets to go to the snack shop. So
he's
actually learning money.
Oh, yeah. Huge.
It's crazy.
A value of a dollar.
Right.
And how much they can get for that dollar.
Yes. He brought a $20 bill there. And
parents.
Yeah, and he bought all the kids ice cream.
Oh, Lord.
And
he's learning how to woo them all.
Right. At least he's giving, I guess.
Hey,
so that's a good thing.
Absolutely.
So tell me something about your background to actually... So first of all, how many years have you been here?
I'm coming to it in my 23rd year here.
Holy smokes.
We have longevity here. We really do.
You do.
We do. And that's flattering if you think about it. I went to Illinois State University. I graduated with my degree in park and recreation.
Okay.
I was at Mundelein Park District for a little bit.
Okay.
But I didn't like the fitness. I was doing fitness over there. But I wanted to come into rec. So I had the opportunity to come back to Grayslake, interview for the recreation position. So I was a recreation supervisor for 17 years.
Holy smokes.
And we have a great succession plan here. They felt that I was the right candidate to move into the superintendent of recreation position, so I did. And now I've held that for 6 or 7 years. We're in 7 years, I think.
Wow, so you have a lot to handle with that.
Yeah. We have fun.
Yeah, you do. Yeah. You know, the turnover in employment is funny because here a lot of the girls that I saw from DJing Park District events, well, I don't even know, what, 15 years ago? Like Kendra, for example.
Yeah, absolutely. Kendra Ring. She's actually at 25 years.
25
this
years?
Year.
Oh,
yes.
My God, do I feel old now. I remember her putting on, like, with the costume suits and running around. She's probably volunteering as a...
That's part of her job description. We have...
Does she still have to
we
do
We could have to dress up at any moment, and it's part of what we do. It's why you go into recreation.
That is hilarious.
She actually, Kendra's, yeah, finishing her 25th year. She started in the front office. And then she's like, you guys have too much fun. Come on. I'm like, come on, let's go. And so she came into recreation. And she hasn't left yet. She did a little stint doing our marketing. But now, and today, we have a brand new marketing person. She's starting today. And we're like, we don't think you know what you're in for, but that's okay. You'll learn.
Yeah. If maybe she'll listen to this podcast, and then she'll find out everything that's going on and everything she has to market.
We don't want to tell her all the secrets.
Right. So just don't listen.
No,
don't listen if you're that part. So your background, you really wanted to do Parks and Recs.
Like, absolutely.
Is there something in your childhood that said, I have to do this?
Like, yes. Okay. My parents, I grew up in Mundelein.
Okay.
So part of growing up in Mundelein, we lived on Diamond Lake.
Yeah.
So I was always in the water. We played softball. We had volleyball. I was raised in a time, probably very much like yours, where you left the house and you came back before the sunset.
Amen.
We actually had neighbors with a giant bell. When that bell would ring, everybody would start scurrying home. So yes, I grew up in rec classes, and it's been a study found many years ago. If you participate in recreation as a child, it will be a lifelong process. You will continue to participate in recreation programs as you age, and have your children participate in Park and Rec.
And especially in 2023, how important is it to teach our children to be active, to be a part of community, to keep going forward and make friends and be social?
It's fundamentally, but that's not new. I mean, that goes back all the way to the 70s, being active in your community. But it also gives kids roots. So I raised my girls very much wanting the same philosophy that I grew up in. Go out, be active. My girls grew up here, not living in Grayslake, but participating in Grayslake activities.
Mm.
And I look at them now and, you know, they're exactly how I wanted to set them up for the future, personally. But I think that exposure to new experiences, it's fundamentally important.
Right. And besides having the kids at classes, I also see the Park District give back to the community in a lot of ways that you employ a lot of young adults here.
Yes, we do. We are first-time employers for a lot of our high school and college kids. And it's important. It's important for us. We've actually redirected a lot of college kids' lives without intention. But, I mean, one of my favorite employees, I have a number of them, but he was going into architecture.
Okay.
And the next summer I talked to him, he goes, yeah, I changed my major.
To what?
What are you doing?
Oh, no.
He's now a very successful teacher at Stevenson High School.
That is fantastic.
He hadn't been exposed to working with kids. And let me tell you, he is an absolute natural. And when you saw, when it clicked, it made perfect sense. And he's teaching, he loves it. And it's an exposure that you don't know until you're in it. Whether you're working at concessions out at Allegheny,
right.
Whether you're field supervising for us out at Allegheny or even out at Central Park, you don't know what you like until you have your feet in it.
Right. And my family's been fortunate enough that my Lily, you know, started off, you know, doing concessions and things. And
well, volunteering first.
That's right.
Volunteering for many of events.
That's right.
We put her to work.
I know.
She works very hard, and we appreciate that.
But now her goal is that she told me that when she grows up, she wants to be in childcare, and she loves doing what she did. Can I work at the Park District here? Can I do this? Can I do that? And she's always looking for a way to be around children to help out.
Mm-hmm.
And I think the staff here, especially the way that you guys treat your staff, also makes her want to come to work because everybody here is so friendly.
Good.
Yeah.
Good.
Except for Tracy.
She's a handful. But let me tell you, whenever she goes on vacation and I have to do bits and pieces of her job, I just shake my head going, oh my goodness. Okay. Do you have to be firm?
What is Tracy? What's
Tracy oversees. She's a recreation supervisor. She oversees, and I'm not going to get all of it right, special events, our affiliates, our field rentals, our facility birthdays, youth programs, adult programs, fitness, you name it. We all carry different areas of responsibility and areas of interest, and they are very different some days. So she has to contend with, she works directly with the high school, making sure that all of our facility, our parks in Central Park work with their athletic schedule.
Oh my gosh.
Which changes sure. the minute it rains.
Amen.
Drastically.
Amen.
So, and she's contending lots of busyness. Taste
wow.
of Grayslake is hers. Pumpkin Fest is hers. We work collaboratively. We work as a team. We don't leave it for one person. But if you're going to find the binder, it's in her office, and she's got all those contractuals in line, and she knows where everybody has to be, how they're going to be there, our certificates of insurance, our health department permits. She's orchestrating a big orchestra.
I officially don't want her job.
I know.
And I get to work with her at the the daddy-daughter dances, mm-hmm. the mother-son dances.
Mm-hmm. Fishing derby.
Fishing derby.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, my gosh. And Pumpkin Fest is a favorite of mine, too.
Yes. And you also do the kickoff dance
down
at Jones Island.
Dance.
Summer kickoff dance.
Wow.
I know.
And I've been employed by the Park District for, I think, 25 years, too, that we've been involved doing things.
Oh, yeah.
So we
there.
Get to see everything. And it seems like a lot of those events, too, aren't just done by you guys. They're with the help of some Grayslake sponsors as well.
Great point. Very great point.
Who are the biggest
yes.
contributors sponsorship-wise?
Oh, goodness.
Here?
I'm not going to highlight anyone over the other, but we do. We have a great sponsorship program. We have great businesses in Lake County. I don't want to miss anybody to leave anybody out.
Right.
But we do, in our sponsorship package, we're definitely acknowledging great local businesses.
Very much so.
We also collaborate with the chamber, with organizations, with the high school. Like, collaboration is key to success in an organization such as ours. So, yes, between our sponsors and other affiliates and organizations in this community, we're here. We're here to help and here to make a program or make an event as best that we can, whether we're providing the space or the equipment, personnel, characters.
Right.
We do have a few characters.
You do, well, yeah, figuratively and literally.
Yes, absolutely.
I can think of a couple of each.
And I'm one of them. Yep, absolutely.
That's the reason I'm sitting here right now. So this is an overwhelming conversation. I can't imagine somebody's like driving in their car right now listening to this going, oh, my God, they do all this stuff. So I know that there is a mailer. Your booklet that's mailed out? Is that
not
still
anymore.
Out? Not
that's a little old school, Dave.
Okay, sorry. I probably don't get my mail anyway.
Yeah, I was going to say, I don't know about you, but I don't get much of the mail. Actually, our program guide is seasonal, so we do 4 program guides.
Okay.
And they are on our website, glpd.com.
glpd.com.
Yep.
Okay.
And the seasonal book, it varies. We also offer a summer camp book, so that just for summer camp. And I'm trying to get yard signs out when it goes up. We put it on Facebook. Our Facebook page, Grayslake Park District, is where we put a lot of stuff.
Okay.
Last minute, like, hey, did you know we're offering a parent taught class? Or did you know we have an early childhood class coming up? Because I don't know about everybody else, but my life gets busy.
Right.
And things slip through the cracks. So, yes, our Facebook page is a great place to go back and reference. It's also where we plug in a few little tidbits. We also do a countdown to when our program guide will launch. So we
Excellent.
Are right now working on our fall program guide.
Okay.
And if all goes right, and you know, no curveballs come our way, we're hoping to launch our fall program guide on August 8th, okay. and that will cover the months of September through December.
Okay.
So we also have a lot of events going on in December. And we all try to take a small sabbatical come January for
yeah,
a few days.
Yeah, I bet.
But
yeah, and there's so much just putting together those program guides and getting them on the website. And if there's any changes, must be just a nightmare in itself.
Oh, we sit for many proofs, so we try to make sure our dates and our times. But yet, curveballs happen, changes happen, and we flex and adjust as quick as we can.
Right. The other thing that I would like to note to listeners, too, is that I've been a victim of is that sometimes I'm behind on things, and it's so important. I'm sure that the day that, like, summer camp, all-day summer camp opens, people are lined up to make sure that they get their kids in there. So it's important to mark those dates on your calendar.
It is. It's helpful. But we do understand, and we try our best, except for when it comes to summer camp, it's a little bit of a hard, now that we have field trips back in, it's a little bit of a hard one to be extremely flexible with that.
Right.
But we do our darndest. If we have the availability in the room, we're kind of old school. Give us a call.
Yeah.
Stop in.
And you've accommodated me when I needed, like, I needed a Tuesday and a Thursday or a Monday, Wednesday, Friday.
Because we have daily options for summer camp.
Right.
Which is crazy. And our staff are incredibly amazing to handle that kind of flux.
Yeah, I can't even believe it. Lisa, I saw this morning, and Lisa over there is just, seems like she's juggling cats on fire.
She is.
And smiling the whole time.
Hopefully.
And then I see you later on at night at Allegheny doing concessions.
We definitely attract a certain kind of person to work here.
This is
like,
for sure.
You have to be, and I myself, you have to be willing to switch gears quick.
Right.
You got to be open to like new experiences. If you're a very set, regimented person, this may not be a field for you. But if you're flexible, you could do so many things.
Yeah, I would love for you to write down a piece of paper like everything in the last month you've did from, you know, from bingo to the list would be huge.
Well, you know what? It's fun. I can never say, and that's one thing I always warn people in recreation, we can never say our days are exactly the same day after day, Monday through Friday, Monday through Sunday, realistically, changes. It changes greatly, whether it's Bryce Walsh with travel softball, T-ball, Tracy with little soccer for tots, Kendra with summer camp, with preschool, with dance. We do. We adjust. We go. We change gears quickly. We pivot quickly.
You have to.
But that's okay. We're here. We've all been doing this long enough to know exactly what we're in for. So we have fun.
Yeah, and you have birthday party rentals in here too?
Absolutely.
Yeah, that's what every time I hear of something, I think the message that I really want to get across is when people complain maybe there's not enough going on in our town, maybe just take a visit over here and find out what's available.
But it's not just us. Yes, the Park District, definitely we have a lot going on. We have a lot of opportunities. But we have a great library. We have a great chamber. We have this town and organizations and providing activities is endless.
It is.
And if you don't have something on your calendar, that's by choice. It's not because it's not an option to fill it.
Can you help me get things off of my calendar?
If I can figure it out for you, I better figure it out for me too.
Right. Yeah, because nobody has a reason to be bored. I mean, you guys from open gyms, like I'm just trying to think.
During the winter months?
Yeah.
During spring and fall when weather's questionable, Tracy will throw an open gym because we know the kids are home. And if the kids are home and it's been raining for 3 hours, they're not going to be able to go play on the baseball diamonds or on the basketball courts. We got an open gym. Come around. Shoot around the baskets. We're here.
Yeah. When you say they're endless, they really are.
We try to be. But, of course, there's a lot of boxes to check. So we might miss something, but it's not with the intention to miss it. But it's just trying to connect with the right organizations, the right companies to make sure we have a variety of things.
So the programs are constantly adapting too. I'm sure that they're not like one day, one year it could be something else or you find a program works or doesn't work and you change it around?
No. We have some diehard programs. And I mean like diehard programs. We do a fabulous parent top program through us. Our terrific to be twos.
Yeah.
Is a great first-time separation with
two-year-old.
So that has been tried and true for many years. One of my rec instructors like asked me, what do you want to do? And she goes, can I do this? And I said, oh, sure, that's uncharted territory. It has still been here, and I bet you we've been offering it for probably 10-plus years.
Holy cow.
Because the first 3 weeks are with a parent, and then 8 weeks – we transition them. We expose them to the room, to the instructor, with the safety of their parents and the comfort of their parents.
Right.
And then we move it to an early childhood where they start to drop off and separate. Some kids handle it with ease.
Yeah.
Some kids it takes a little bit longer, but we're here to work with them, and that's a process.
Yeah, that's got to be a huge transition. I'm sure those first couple of days for some are probably easy, and some just lose their mind.
And then just preschool. Our preschool program, we have a young threes program. We have our 3-year-olds, our 4-year-olds with an enrichment option available. So you could come 5 days a week. It's really whatever works for a family that they want.
Unbelievable. Unbelievable.
And you can dance, be a prima ballerina at our studio with no ballet experience.
Really?
Yeah. We feel like something that I was always tried and true to my dance director, Megan Reimers. It doesn't matter your ability. If you want to dance, come to us and we'll get you in a dance program and we'll get you in a class. We'll find your interest and we'll work with you.
That's great. So you're not leaving anybody out.
Hopefully not. It's never an intent. Well, and to mention that, we work in conjunction. We're one of the agencies for our Special Recreation Association of Central Lake County. We call it SRACLC. They provide recreation for special populations.
Wow.
And we love it because we're actually going to work with them and offer. So this fall, we offer a bunch of programs, but we're doing the skeleton egg hunt. So we are going to completely separate our 7 o'clock time frame for it's a flashlight egg hunt, but we're going to work with SRA and offer it through them. And it's going to be a family event with our special rec association at 6 o'clock. They get to go do a flashlight egg hunt at Meadowview as long as Pumpkin Fest goes with no rain.
Right.
We got a little variables in place, but yes, SRACLC, we are proud to work with them and provide inclusion aids, one-on-one inclusion aids, or hold their programs here in our building. You name it.
Wow.
We want to, so like when you mentioned we try to do all, yeah. We really try to offer for everyone.
From birth to death.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
It's kind of crazy.
It is. Okay, so you've never listened to a podcast before, admittedly.
Yes.
So at some point during here, we take a break.
Okay.
And this is where we call it the Grayslake Hot Seat.
Oh.
Where we get to know you just a little bit better.
Oh, Lord.
And this portion is brought to us by our friends at Barbecue Productions, which Third Lake, which I still consider Grayslake.
Yes.
Because Chris over there and the guys have and gals have great barbecue over there, and they're friendly enough to sponsor our show.
Do they ever have good barbecue?
Okay, so this is how the Grayslake Hot Seat works.
Okay.
I'm going to ask you a question. You just have a second to answer it. You can pass if you'd like.
Okay.
But I urge you not to.
Okay.
And sometime you guys are going to get bored of hearing this, but I think it's kind of fun with every individual that we get to do. Okay, so I'm just going to bounce around here. Shelly Regnier on the Grayslake Hot Seat.
Yes.
Hey, bartender, can I have a...
Jameson ginger ale with lime.
Boom. Your favorite movie?
Say anything.
Pet peeve.
Being late.
Ooh. Favorite sports team?
Chicago Cubs.
Yes. Highest score in bowling?
Oh, have no idea.
Last show that you binge watched?
Oh, we're watching Outlander right now.
Nice. Do you have a go-to karaoke song?
Absolutely not.
All right. We won't ask you to sing. You can call
no,
bingo, though.
I can.
Have you ever won an award?
No, I don't think so. Not that I would even...
Not that you're going to tell us, anyway.
Maybe so.
With your schedule, I'm assuming, or no. How many times do you exercise per week?
Wrong answer, but four to five times a week.
Awesome. Favorite candy?
Oh, cowtails.
Yes. What makes you sweaty? Okay.
Life.
Exactly. Is there anything you're really afraid of?
Snakes.
Nice. What's your favorite season?
Fall.
Does your car have a nickname?
Yep. Audisha.
What is it?
Audisha.
Sounds good. I'm not going to go any further with that. Are you a texting or a talking gal?
Both.
Oh. Toilet paper. Do you roll it over or do you roll it under?
Over.
Yeah, see, maybe I need to take that one off. Everybody has that. Tell me about the second time you were arrested.
Well, there had to be a first.
That's why I love it. Name a celebrity that you have met.
Oh, stink. I'm going to blink on his name. Oh, he was a former wrestler. Yeah, I met him in Nebraska.
All right. Sounds good. Last thing you purchased on Amazon.
I have a giant love sack in my basement. I'm getting a mattress container to suck the air out of it. It arrived yesterday.
You should see the passion on her face right now on how she's excited about
this. Condense that ginormous love sack.
And we'll end with who's your favorite band?
Mr. Myers.
Okay. No, we're not going to end with that one. Your favorite Grayslake event? Park District event?
I can't. Pumpkin Fest, Taste of Grayslake, family bingo, anything. I love special events.
And you have so many. So yep. Thank you for being kind with that. And
no problem.
I'm glad you haven't been arrested once.
No.
I also want to cover a couple of more things that I think are very unique here. And, mm-hmm. I think it all comes back to the staff. Even like Chris Split.
Kristen.
Mm-hmm. I'm sorry.
No. Kristen Split. We call her Chris. We call her Chris.
So, you know, years ago, like over the last 25 years. So what is Kristen's role here now?
Kristen Split is our executive director.
So she's the big dog here.
She is the big boss.
Yes. And she's so nice, though.
I know. And that's why I think it's culture. I was actually just talking about it this morning with a couple other, they're now executive directors. It's culture. We have, and I jokingly say, if you want me to micromanage you, I'm sorry, I can't. I've never been micromanaged. We work as a team here. And it's not just a phrase, a catchy employment phrase. We collaborate together. I think we support each other in such a way. But that comes from the top down. Chris hired me 23 years ago. She finished her 25th year here last year. So she's in her 26th year. Getting close to wrapping those up, too. It's all a matter of we do our darndest to treat everybody with respect and kindness. We try the darndest to keep an open mind. Like, I always say, yeah, we've done this in the past. That's how we've done it. That doesn't mean moving forward we do it the same way. So if somebody comes with another idea, oh, okay, let's work on that.
Love it.
We just had that conversation with Dustin Cherico over at the high school, wanting to bring back an event that we haven't held in a long time. Okay, if we do that and we do it here, then we start brainstorming. So like when we try to do program guide and that trip's coming up or an activity's coming up and we're trying to figure a new route, a new change, we all talk about it. It's never something that you're on your own to problem solve. Wow. So I think something about that, and that we spend more time together than with our own families.
There's a lot to be said about that,
so
too.
So there's kind of like that respecting each other, honoring each other, willingness to work together. Tracy stopped in my office this morning. She said, what are you doing tomorrow? I said, well, I got this, this, and that. Can you run to Sam's with me? Sure. Let's go. I got to get stuff for the golf course. She's got to get stuff for concessions. But we go. I mean, it doesn't happen like that everywhere else.
No.
And we didn't realize that, but then we've started to come to realize we have a great environment. And that is one of those reasons why I think you see us all in our, working 20-plus years together. Even our front office.
Yeah.
Vicky, Karen, Janet is our business manager. She's the newest rookie, and I think she's at 7 years. Chris hired her.
Wow.
In that position.
Yeah, and this is one of the only places I can walk in, and I know almost everybody here.
And there's something to be said about that. That is something that I think is comforting to people.
Yes,
like you can come in.
Yes, huge.
Right.
And I can ask questions. What the heck is this class about?
Yeah.
Or how do I sign up for this? Yeah. I got a problem. I need this, but I have this.
Mm-hmm. And we'll problem solve with you. We'll already have the solution and we'll just let you know that these are your options. And because there's no right or wrong, there's no black or white. We have options. We kind of do this. This is recreation.
Right.
This shouldn't stress us out beyond belief. We're here. We're going to work with our parents the best that we can. We're going to work with our contractuals the best that we can. We'll work with our affiliates to the best we can. We'll support local organizations to the best that we can.
Yes.
And that keeps us running circles. Don't mind that. But we're happy to play nice at the playground, is my phrase.
Right.
We do. We try. We try to take pride in it. We ask our campers to do it. We ask our preschoolers to do it. Then we as adults should lead by example.
Right. Wow. That's an extremely powerful paragraph or two that you just spit out of your mouth. Like, but you can tell how passionate you are.
It is.
About
it's kind of like my those are my life mottos, I guess.
Right.
And incorporating it where I work and being a part of it, it is meaningful to me. It really is.
I can see that. And if everybody's watching this right now, you could see how important it is too. All right. So as a community, mm-hmm. is there anything that the Park District, let's say I wanted to help the Park District or donate some things or for an event coming up or anything to, you know, enhance a program you have. Are you looking for people to do that? Are you looking for sponsorships for other events? How could other Grayslake businesses get involved to help out all the hard work that you're doing here?
Well, it's a great question. Our poor brand new marketing gal, she knows she's going into sponsorship, but she's not been launched into it yet. But yeah, no, it's a tag team effort. Sponsorships are huge for us. Okay. So somebody, a business sponsoring us, we're going to take, whether it's a monetary, whether it's, oh, we can provide staff for you to do this event. Okay, we're going to work. We're going to work collaboratively with whoever wants to sponsor. If you want a monetary thing, then we're going to definitely tell you, okay, your $500 that you sponsored, this is our package, this is what we'll do for you. And, of course, every sponsor is always invited to whatever they're sponsoring.
Yes, and so, I've been at places where they have their booths, even
yes,
at the summer kickoff dance.
Yes.
We had Grayslake Orthodontist. We
absolutely
had Grayslake Dentist. We had another guy from a beverage company, and they all have
Polar.
What a cool guy too.
Yeah.
And he was at the fireworks as well.
Yes.
Yeah. But
yes,
just having them there
and
to represent themselves.
And we have
too
a ton of sponsors in Grayslake. I mean, like I said, I can't even begin to start listing them out because I don't want to miss anybody.
Understood.
And because I know I'll miss somebody, and then I don't want to offend anybody because
right,
everybody who sponsors, they're a great part of our team, and we greatly appreciate it. But we do have a sponsorship package if somebody wants to. If a company wants to say, we'll work at Pumpkin Fest, we've had that happen.
Oh, just volunteers just to
yes,
come and help?
Yes, volunteer at the games.
I wouldn't think about that.
Yeah, it's helpful because there were times, not right now, but there were times where we couldn't find staff. Staffing can be a struggle some days. And once our college kids from summer camp go back to school, our staffing thins out. So
right,
we lose a number of our camp counselors to school, and we have a huge event coming up. So,
nice,
yeah, we've had companies say, we're going to send 10 staff out your way. Oh, we're going to give you a job. It's going to be a really stressful job. Like Bozo buckets.
Oh, yes.
Bingo.
Yes. You're kidding, right.
The wheel, and you're always giving a prize away. So those stressful jobs come with a big smile and hopefully a lot of fun
and
laughter.
Oh, they're rewarding to do.
Hopefully.
They are.
It is fulfilling. I try to volunteer when I have the time.
Yeah. I think the hardest thing that I do for the Park District is trying to run your costume contest at Pumpkin Fest.
Oh, it is. I've had to lead the concert or the costume contest.
Oh, I was out of town the last couple of years. Maybe
oh
you have
God
to do that. Should I yeah be out of town again?
No. No. I don't use the microphone. I mean, I'm always in Maleficent costume.
Yes.
So now costume people might actually recognize who they're hearing.
Oh,
I'm
right
always in the Maleficent costume. And I'm the one, I got to get these kids round up. We're never going to see all these costumes. And off I started with a cha-cha line or whatever it's called.
Right.
And it is so much fun. But I love Pumpkin Fest and the fact the families that come out in full family gear.
Thank you.
Oh my God, out of the ballpark.
Outfits, right.
Amazing. I am so envious. So I could never even think about it.
And Halloween's like my favorite holiday.
It
so
is.
Watch when the whole family dresses up as the Addams Family or something from
S'mores. I think we had S'mores one year.
Really?
Oh my God. Parents were in the graham cracker. One was a marshmallow and one was a chocolate bar. It was absolutely amazing.
It was great. So step up your game, Grayslake.
Oh, my gosh. I'm sorry, Grayslake.
Pumpkin Fest
is
coming.
Yeah.
It's coming fast. It actually...
October 19th?
Yeah.
I might be giving the wrong
date. And I hate to put dates on this, but, you know, if somebody listens to this a year from now,
It's still in October.
It's still going to be relevant to what they're looking at.
I hope so.
So I'm encouraging the community to get involved. First of all, go like the Facebook page and make sure to check on that. And
mm-hmm,
and here's the thing about Facebook. Interact with it. Like things. Maybe put stuff on. Otherwise, it's just going to disappear. So get on Grayslake. It's just Grayslake Park District.
Grayslake Park District.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
And hopefully you'll found this link because this has been reposted there. If Shelly lets us lets us do that.
I'm terrified, but of course.
No, this has been a lot of fun.
Yes,
I feel
yes
like there's so many other things that we haven't covered. But if you want information about the Park District, go to glpd.com.
Yep.
Follow on Facebook. And if you have a question about
Stop
over
in
here.
We're still kind of old school. We got ladies at the front desk. Vicky and Lori
yeah
are always happy to answer a phone call or chat over the counter.
Right. And you make a phone call and it's not automated.
No automated.
Thank you.
No.
Thank you for
We're
that.
Kind of old. There are some things you have to be old school about. and interaction and people skills have to still exist. And we're kind of still that way. We want to be. We take an honest effort to be face-to-face.
Yes. And I want to commend you on it because there's so many things and people that if you're not in a job like some of us has been where we actually deal with the public, there are so, and especially the way the world's going, it's 2023 and everybody is sensitive about everything.
Yes.
So for you to show up with such enthusiasm and everybody that works here to have so much enthusiasm to do good, to provide the community with great everything from top to bottom.
Thank you.
I'm sure that you guys deal with a lot of BS on the side. Mostly great, I'm sure.
Only on the side.
Right, and just a little bit. So if you have a just bad attitude, you can go somewhere else. And that's me saying that. That's not Shelly.
We'll try.
Right, but there's something for everybody. And you know what, everybody, and we all learn. That's the way, I'm sure, with anything you do at any place. If you get a complaint or a criticism, I know me DJing, I've had criticized maybe it's, once or twice.
It's called constructive criticism. It's okay.
Right.
You don't break.
Right.
And we do. We send out evaluations at the end of programs, and we value that feedback.
Yes.
Because we can't change something we don't know about.
Right.
We can't adjust it. So tell us.
Right.
We're okay.
We don't do everything, right?
No. I'm not going to take it personally.
Right.
It's not a me individual. It's, you know, we're trying to put something together, and sometimes we knock it out of the park. Sometimes we're off just a smidget.
Yeah.
And we don't mind hearing that we might be off a little bit. We love to hear when we get it right.
Right, yeah. You're allowed to send in positive criticism as well.
We
yes.
don't mind that. And you know what? We have an amazing camp parent dropping off lunch for the camp counselors this week because they appreciate the work that goes into running summer camp.
See, that's
and
awesome.
Those things kind of sometimes get slipped by. We have a couple parents that every day, our camp director has mentioned, he commends and his thank you is so enthusiastic, they feel it. And right. I think reminding people that we're doing the best, we have the best intentions to set forth moving forward, and our purpose is real.
It is.
And we're trying.
Right.
We're trying.
And imagine what those thank yous and handshakes or high fives mean to a young employee here, maybe working at adventure camp
it's
or
huge.
Working at day camp. Like and that also teaches them to show appreciation and gratitude for wherever they're giving it back.
Absolutely.
So I think it's a lesson to be learned there all the way down from
every
top to
day
bottom.
Is a lesson to be learned.
All right, so we're going to wrap this up. Do me a favor, friends, if you are listening, do me a favor, try repost this on your Facebook, repost this on your Instagram, share it with some friends, share it with people that are involved in the Park District, and probably more importantly, share it with people that aren't involved with the Park District.
Yeah.
Because we want to build community, and that's the whole new reason that we're doing this.
Absolutely.
Is to try to build community. So, Shelly, I appreciate your time.
Of course,
hanging
anytime.
Out with me. And speaking of complaints that we were talking about, I'm actually considering being the guest bingo caller at one.
I think you should do it.
All right. We'll have to report back on
B12.
That. B12.
Yeah. 1-2. You can do
and
it.
And I have to keep it clean, though, right?
I try.
I mean me, not
oh,
you.
Yeah.
I mean you
oh,
have
yeah.
to.
Sometimes.
So we'll check back in to see if I get fired after my first day of bingo calling.
It takes a lot to get fired.
Okay, folks, of whatever podcast platform you're listening on, please do me a favor. Hit the subscribe button. I know it sounds so generic to say hit the subscribe button, but if you subscribe on Apple or Spotify, every time a new episode comes out, you'll be alerted. So that way you don't miss a thing. Our town is so important. We're building community, so let's all work together. And move forward to make it even better than it can be.
And I'll be subscribing this evening.
All right. Yes. All right. Thank you, everybody. And thank you, Shelly.
Thank you.